this is it. You got to go out there and lay it all on the line every play.
We had three guys on the floor in one possession.
What a wicked pace this game is going at.
That's what it's about.
I told the guys, a loss is a loss. We can't dwell on that.
Starting to see the desperation of the Tigers.
Tigers are in a cage. We got to pick it up.
Who's Daryl Cuoleto making things happen for the Tigers?
We are defending champions until they beat us.
We get what we want, fellas.
This game has desperation written all over it.
This is it.
And they are now just one win away from their first championship in 20 years.
Well, it's been great, but we want to try to get it done in Melbourne.
And Brisbane are looking the goods.
Be up right here, fellas.
It's a certain calm of the Brisbane Bullets.
Is this it? Hopefully.
Ebi Ara and the Brisbane Bullets already have one hand on the NBL Championship trophy, but the Queenslanders need one more win over the Melbourne Tigers before they can win the title for the first time in 20 years. And the reigning champs aren't ready to hand over their trophy just yet. Chris Anstey had his worst game of the season 48 hours ago. Expect him to light it up, along with Sam McKinnon, after both were named in the All-Star 5 today. And Sam McKinnon is the best defensive player, the MVP. Now he wants the ring, because he would swap all those individual accolades to get the championship that has eluded him since 1996. Hello, everybody. It's great to have your company here at the Cage in Melbourne. Another fabulous atmosphere as the Tigers' championship hopes go on the line. They need to bounce back, and my regular sparring partner, NBL Hall of Famer Steve Carfino, thinks they can. You believe we're going to game five.
Let's not forget how the Tigers got here. They are big across the board, and they are in a desperate situation. Season on the line, that means they're going to go after every single loose ball like it's their last game of the year. They're going to go after every offensive rebound. And when they go after the glass like that, the Tigers are hard to beat.
And Melbourne's co-captain Chris Anstey summed up the situation when he said, there is no tomorrow if they lose here.
Well, that's just it. It's do or die. So if we have another bad game like we did on whenever game three was, you know, we're done for the year. It's simple as that. So yeah, you do get games like that. You hope they don't happen in a grand final series, but it did. We put it behind us, and you know, we all know we can play basketball. We won't all miss the shots we missed last game, and we're hoping that we shoot the ball better, because I think that just, you know, gives you an extra step on defense. It gives you a bit more confidence, and sometimes that's all it takes to get over the top of a team like Brisbane.
In game two here at this venue last Sunday, Chris Anstey had 31 points, the highest individual score at any stage during the playoffs. 48 hours ago, Steve, he had 9 points. I think he'll be closer to 31 tonight.
Well, if he doesn't get 31, he's going to be a lot more active, that's for sure. His team will do a better job of getting him the basketball in a scoring position. They'll put him in a position to succeed. And then when he gets the basketball, Brisbane double-team him. If Brisbane run a lot of stunts at him, he'll find his teammates. And I'm sure, like I said about going after the loose balls and the offensive rebounds, we're going to see a lot more cuts from the Melbourne Tigers tonight.
Well, this NBL epic began a week ago in Brisbane, and it was the Bullets who got the job done by three after Melbourne had led for 82% of the match. They returned here to the Cage for game two, and Melbourne took it by 14 points, but had to come from nine down at halftime to tie the series away. The home team prevailed again in game three, with Brisbane winning by 20. That brings us here to game four tonight, and possibly game five on Sunday night. But this series has had it all. Big game players, and in game one, Melbourne really should have taken the honors.
Sure did. They got a great start. They were really pumping on the defensive end of the floor, and they were knocking shots down. They looked like they were really dictating the terms. Then Brisbane, they didn't win 21 in a row just by accident. They got their fast break going on the back of some good D and got the win. In game two, Brisbane got off to the good start. Mick Hill came off the bench. It was great for them. Really pumped up. And Chris Anstey takes a big blow from Mark Bradtke, showing you the intensity that we had and the desperation that we had in game two. But it was Chris Anstey coming up with 31 points in game two, and he got his team back on track, tied it up. Game three, it would have been the decider if we weren't going to five. Adam Gibson came off of the bench, knocking down 14 points, also getting it going on the defensive end of the floor. It was all Brisbane Bullets. They got their fast break going, and they got the edge in the series with a great defense. Their MVP of the year, Sam McKinnon, was great on both ends of the floor, getting it to Adam Gibson. What a great series that he has had so far, but the man who's had the best is Stephen Black. He has been on fire. He has been the man that they've gone to in tight situations, and he's done a great job pressuring the basketball up the court in their extended pressure on Daryl McDonald.
He's been the game high scorer in two of the grand final matches played so far. And we're going to have a look at the starting lineups for both teams. And both are going back to their original fives that they've used throughout the series.
They're going to get some big stuff from Chris Anstey. I can just feel it. Great atmosphere here in Melbourne. Stephen Horr has been spectacular here in the grand final. Game three especially. Rashad Tucker needs to get it going in the open court. Needs to help out Daryl McDonald, bringing it up against that very good Brisbane extended pressure. In the backcourt for the Melbourne Tigers, very key, of course, Daryl McDonald. He's got to dictate the tempo that the Tigers want, and Dave Thomas needs to come up big. He's had big games in big situations throughout his entire career, college, professional, and he needs to do it tonight. Backs to the wall and coming off the bench for the Tigers. This is where they need a boost. They need to get a big one from Daryl Corletto. They got a good one last time they were in this building. David Stipp needs to make more of an impact. Also, Nathan Crosswell is such a key in this game because he's got to get Daryl McDonald some rest, and he's also got to be aggressive against that extended pressure that we talked so much about. And Axel Dench needs to step it up too, because he needs to play big when they throw the ball down to him down on the block. He's got a smaller man on his back. He's got to make him pay.
Exactly right. And the team whose bench has been the high scorer in the game but won all three of the grand final matches so far, don't underestimate how important those bench players will be. The Brisbane Bullets will ever Abi Ora, who represented Nigeria at the World Championships last year, has been a lucky charm. He's playing his second season in Australia. He won in his only other season with the Sydney Kings, looking to make it a double here. Dusty Ryker, tremendous comeback in Game 3 after being scoreless here at this venue in Game 2. And Sam McKinnon, the best player in the league, has been dominating the Tigers with his suffocating D. CJ Bruton is in the grand final for the fourth straight year, looking for his third title. And as Steve Carfino has told you, Stephen Black has been shooting the lights out. He was quiet in the semi-finals. He's bounced back looking for his second title. Adam Gibson has hit 6 of 8 threes during the playoffs. This has been his breakout series. Brad Williamson hit 9 threes in a single game and is a dangerous commodity. Mick Hill back here, a Melbourne-born player, played his junior ball with Dandenong. Dylan Boucher, a 6-time New Zealand NBL champion, looking for his first title. And Mark Bradtke, who had 13 seasons here with the Tigers, winning 2 titles. Well, he's looking to turn the tables and win a championship with Brisbane. So much on the line here. So many big matchups, Steve. Who's going to win?
Oh, this is how much respect I have for the Tigers, because I think the Brisbane Bullets are pretty much unbeatable, but I think they're going to dig down. They're going to find something special. And the Tigers are going to send this one to 5.
Another tremendous atmosphere at the cage in Melbourne as the Tigers play host to the Brisbane Bullets in Game 4 of the Grand Final Series. Melbourne have won 17 of their 19 matches here this season, but the Brisbane Bullets came here earlier in the year and got the job done in double overtime. Our referees, Scott Butler, Michael Allen and Billy Mildenhall, have done every Grand Final for the last 21 years between them. Scott Butler will do the honours, and the Melbourne Tigers control the tip. They work to the right of your screen, looking to make amends for a 20-point loss in Brisbane 48 hours ago. Anstey posts up McKinnon straight away. He's strong with the ball, and Michael Allen gets the first foul. We've played 14 seconds. Steve Carfino's looked into that crystal ball and come up with a good cigar.
The crowd is going to be riding every single time. There's an arm bar on one of their big guys. Quick whistle straight away. Tigers establish Chris Anstey in the first half a minute of the game.
Tucker posting up Abi Ora, takes a bump, goes to work, it rattles around the rim, and it tumbles for Rashad Tucker.
They need to get good shots every single time, as explosive as the Bullets are.
McKinnon gets it from Stephen Black. Reichardt rolls to the hoop, got away from Anstey and open, scoring for the Brisbane Bullets.
Well, Dusty Reichardt got his game going early in game three. That was a big plus for him. 17 points in the first half in game three.
Now Tucker again works down low and off the window. Rashad Tucker comes up with another two. He's been the best rebounder for the Tigers in the playoffs. Their second leading scorer as well, as Reichardt puts it on the floor once more and straight back at the Tigers. It's Reichardt versus Tucker.
Ahead, ahead.
Dave Thomas guarded by CJ Bruton. Anstey posting up. McKinnon had a good seal, but they can't find a passing lane at the moment. Now they do. Outside, getting it back. Single coverage from McKinnon. Now the double team arrives. Anstey goes to work and comes up with a two.
Three shots inside the paint for the Tigers.
Now McKinnon running out of room. Shut down by Anstey. Retreats to Ebi Arak. Reichardt against Stephen Hoare. Likes his chances from close range. Couldn't convert. So after five straight scores, Brisbane come up empty. Anstey wrestling with McKinnon. Got away with a good shove and then threw down the dunk as well. The Tigers have a four-point lead.
Well, we haven't seen a shot outside of the paint for either team. Sam McKinnon pleading his case with Billy Mildenhall. No call down there as Anstey gets the pass and the dunk.
Anstey was none of eight at halftime 48 hours ago. Two of two already. McKinnon's lost the handle. So has Rashad Tucker. Reichardt to Bruton. Single digits on the shot clock. Reichardt shut down by a good D from Chris Anstey. The ball comes out to Dave Thomas. Tucker in support. Pass didn't do him any favors. A chance for a quick transition play. But Tucker backing in Ebi Arak. Gets a double team, but steps between and then short-armed it. Couldn't get enough on it, but Brisbane knock it out of court. 11 on the shot clock for Melbourne.
Chris Anstey, 7 foot every single night. He'll make plays for that, like that, anytime you come in and don't show him a good move.
Dave Thomas elevates for the three, can't complete it, and McKinnon grabs the rebound ahead of Chris Anstey. Now picks off the dribble. Ebi Arak bumps into Tucker, who's called for the foul. First infringement on the Melbourne Tigers.
Jerry Wright working the sideline. Didn't think he was going to get that one initially.
Bruton to Stephen Black, who works to the foul line. Caught it a little deep. McKinnon trying to keep it alive. Tucker grabs the loose ball. McDonald has Dave Thomas in support. Has CJ Bruton on the back pedal. Can't complete it. Dave Thomas tip-in wouldn't tumble either. And Brisbane with an opportunity here as Stephen Black gets it from Bruton and is called for an offensive foul as he knocks down Chris Anstey.
Chris Anstey was in retreat. Just goes with the shoulder. As soon as he felt that one, took the flop. Stephen Black just a little out of control.
McDonald relieved of it by Dusty Reichardt. McDonald returns the favor, but did it illegally according to Billy Mildenhall. And we're going to see free throws for the first time tonight. An energized Dusty Reichardt reading the play well here.
Don't see this happen to Daryl McDonald very often. Daryl McDonald puts the hand up, got a lot more ball than he probably anticipated.
Dusty Reichardt playing in his first grand final series in the NBL. He's just one of six from the free throw line in the playoffs. Shot the ball at 53% from the free throw line during the regular season. Two on this occasion. So Melbourne with a three-point lead. We played a little over 3 minutes here. Term number one. Tucker over the halfway line with a second to spare. Guarded by Ebi Arak. Anstey and McKinnon wrestling down in the low block. Likewise, McDonald and Stephen Black in that category. And McDonald steps through off the rim. And Ebi Arak grabs the loose ball. Gets it back from Stephen Black. Now Bruton, the quarterback, who's happy to be pass first in the early stages of the match until they require his scoring as well. McKinnon turning around on Stephen Hoare, and the MVP opens his scoring account.
Well, when he's got that popping, you are in for a long night because he's so dangerous off the dribble.
Tucker works it to Stephen Hoare. He couldn't handle the pass, and the Tigers turn it over for the second time. Likewise, Brisbane has two turnovers in the match.
Tigers have to be so efficient because the Bullets have so many weapons and they're all shooting the basketball with so much confidence.
Bruton showed it to Darryl McDonald. 10 on the shot clock. He steps through a couple of defenders and from close range, CJ Bruton opens his scoring account. Brisbane have scored the last 7 points here and they take over by one.
You know, you just know that's not going to happen. Stephen Black up and in, body contact. The crowd's going to be riding it. He won't be able to pressure the same as he did. There's the body. Stephen Black and the Brisbane Bullets wanted the push off from Darryl McDonald, but they called the bump before that. Now Adam Gibson will be coming in with the same intensity. Let's see if they continue to enforce that and not allow the body contact.
Stephen Black fouled out in game two of the grand final series at this venue. He's picked up two quick ones here inside the first 5 minutes. Rashad Tucker posting up Ebi Urah, works to the baseline and from close range gets a high percentage play.
So tough. It's so hard to guard him without giving up ground. Ebi Urah for three.
Gordon deep. Dave Thomas resting with Reichardt, drags down the rebound. Now off and running to Stephen Hoare, who draws Reichardt. Thomas to McDonald around the perimeter. Here's Anthony stepping inside. Ebi Urah, who's called for the foul. It's his first and the fourth on Brisbane. We play the tick over. 5 minutes here, term number one. To the boos of the crowd, we're going to see Dylan Boucher join in. Mark Bradtke checks in as well. Reichardt and Ebi Urah go to the bench.
I'm not sure who they're booing for. They were booing Chris Anstey. I mean, Mark Bradtke last time with that incident he had with Chris Anstey.
I think Dylan Boucher's episode with Daryl Corletto is fresh in their memory from game three. Crosswell into the match for the Tigers, leaving Darryl McDonald. Here's Dave Thomas. Got inside McKinnon. Then bounced into Adam Gibson, and the offensive foul is called on Melbourne. The points are waved away.
Offensive foul on number 11. The lack of control. Could have called either one. Takes the charge, knocks him down, and it took an extra step.
Well, what a series Adam Gibson is having. From Kluin at the foot of the Great Western Tiers in northern Tasmania. He has stepped up big time in his second season. Spent some time with the AIS. Great Tasmanian products. A hot commodity on the free agents list after his performances here in the postseason. Bruton shakes Dave Thomas, who's a good defender. Was a little off balance, couldn't complete the shot, and Anstey puts a stop to it. Rashad Tucker working against Dylan Boucher, was trying to find Nathan Croswell, but sprays the pass. And the Tigers turn it over for the fourth time.
Brisbane force you to make a lot of turnovers. You got to go at them aggressively or you can't match their offense. But their D is so good, they force you into making mistakes.
It was 22 turnovers to 15. Melbourne racked up in game three of this series. McKinnon with single coverage now picks up the dribble. Needs help. Bruton fires the triple. Can't convert. And the Tigers looking to run. Dave Thomas quickly up the floor. Likewise, Tucker. Now Croswell. They move it to Anstey, guarded by McKinnon. Gets a double team. Tucker's available from close range. Rashad Tucker now has 8 of the 12 the Melbourne Tigers have come up with.
Interior passing so good for the Tigers, as we've mentioned throughout the series. But they got to continue to play like this if they want to match Brisbane.
6.5 minutes done in the first term. Shot clock rolls down to 5. McKinnon needs to get busy. A tough shot. Dylan Boucher with a clean up 2 to open his scoring again.
I think you're right, Case. Those boos are for Dylan Boucher.
Croswell looking for Anstey. Foot violation is called. And the fans are letting Dylan Boucher know all about it as well. Hill is in. Bruton is out. Dave Thomas restarts for the Melbourne Tigers. Anstey retreats to Nathan Croswell. Here's the Canadian. Looking for Stephen Hoare, who reels in the pass, knocks down Dylan Boucher taking the shot, but never looked likely. And Brisbane with an opportunity to retake the lead as we move inside the last 5 minutes, term number one. Nick Hill off the bench to Gibson. Now McKinnon. Whistle off the ball provided by Billy Mildenhall. It's going to be the fourth team foul on Melbourne in this turn.
Just trying to check the cutter is Stephen Hoare. David Stiff comes in for him, but that's the type of intensity the Tigers are going to have to play with on both ends of the floor.
Brisbane has four bench players out there at the moment. Bradtke, Boucher, looking for Reichert. Good hands from David Stiff, almost came up with the steal. The Bullets will restart with 17 on the shot clock. Reichert hands over to Adam Gibson against Crosswell. Feels he's got that man covered, and Gibson opens his scoring account.
Boy, as good as he looked in game three, he looks just as poised here in game four.
David Stiff needs help. Crosswell provides it. Bullets have five scorers in the match. Melbourne just two so far. Dave Thomas becomes Melbourne's third scorer. Seesawing affair, term number one. Mick Hill takes on Dave Thomas, beats Bradtke. Dave Thomas got plenty of ball there, but Billy Mildenhall is going to send the Bullets to the free throw line.
Good pass, nice little dish off. Dave Thomas just reaches in with those long arms.
Can't get the user-friendly roll there. No Brisbane players being to the free throw line more than Mark Bradtke in the playoffs. Had an injury-interrupted regular season. He played only 22 of the 33 games. But when it counts, Mark Bradtke has turned up impressively. Rashaan Tucker sits down, replaced by Darryl Corletto.
I believe that's why the Bullets have been able to get to the next level, was Mark Bradtke's play.
Corletto shadowed by Mick Hill. Now Anstey top of the key to David Stiff. Stiff's inside Adam Gibson with a left hand. Couldn't complete it, but Dave Thomas with the athletic tip in gets another two for Melbourne. Mick Hill takes on David Stiff and Anstey. Corletto got a piece of the action as well. Brisbane will restart with 19 on the shot clock.
Well, because the Bullets are used to attack and pressure in training against one another, they go all out every time they get the basketball. Mick Hill for a little jumper.
Couldn't complete it. Moucher taps it away. Anstey scoops up the loose ball. Crosswell fires over Gibson. Front and back of the rim. It wouldn't tumble for Nathan Crosswell. Brisbane with an opportunity as Boucher works into the paint. Overcooked it from close range to the delight of the fans. Dave Thomas brings Melbourne back up the floor. Had Crosswell available in the corner. Is keen to work it to Anstey. Now David Stiff to Dave Thomas, firing over Adam Gibson. Couldn't complete the three, and Boucher grabs the rebound. Getting plenty of treatment from David Stiff, who's picked up the foul, and that's going to send Brisbane to the free throw line.
Well, every game has seen a lot of similarities as David Stiff reaches in, gets called for the foul. We haven't seen one successful shot outside the paint yet by either team.
The Tigers alerting the referees.
He's saying when the... saying when the ball got turned
here we
over,
go, take, take,
he was
take,
heading
take.
Off the gibbo.
Yeah,
that's what hit
in
the face, yeah.
Here's an explanation from Scott Butler. Less than 3 minutes to play, term number one. Adam Gibson can't complete the back end there.
David Stitt puts it on the floor against Dylan Boucher, who's called for the foul, his first, and free throws to come for the Melbourne Tigers.
They're in a load of trouble there. Still giving Dylan Boucher a bit. This has been very close to an 8-second violation.
David Stiff has had 12 turnovers in the 5 playoff games. I'm surprised Melbourne are persisting with him bringing the ball up on occasion, because it has been a nightmare for David Stiff, and the Brisbane Bullets defense are licking their lips every time he's carrying the ball. 2:49 left on the clock here, term number one. Melbourne hold a 1-point lead. Brisbane have been in front as well. Let's see what Joey Wright and his assistants have cooked up here for the last 2 and a bit minutes.
Hey, they're going to be in zone after this, all right? They're going to be in zone. They're going to run the half-court press and drop back to zone. Run dive coming out of this, all right? Dive coming out of this. You be the flash guy, you dive. You set the initial pick. If they're soft on you, you turn the corner and go ahead and knock it down, okay? On the breaking the press, you stay back.
Back on the press.
You stay back. Yeah. You stay back and help, all right?
Yeah.
Hoagie in the middle. Dusty, you go deep, pick you up the sideline, okay? We'll be conservative on breaking.
But you want Dylan, right? You want Dusty in the post or Dylan in the dive?
Man, you're flashing.
Other than that 39-point quarter in game two where the Tigers evened up the series, this game is kind of following the same pattern that really is in favor of Brisbane. Melbourne are kind of doing what they want to do. They're moving the basketball. They're getting a lot of looks inside the paint. And Brisbane haven't really played to the level that they're capable of playing. Not saying they're not playing hard or not executing their stuff, but we haven't seen a lot of big shots from the perimeter, them in transition, and what they do so well. So if the game keeps going like this, unless Melbourne break out and do something really special, you got to feel like Brisbane are going to close this thing off tonight.
Gibson gets it back from Reichardt, penetrates, no passing lane available. Boucher finds Bradtke and gets it back. He's fouled by Axel Dench, going hard to the rack. Boucher adds the two and a chance at a 3-point play.
Great cut by Dylan Boucher. And he is definitely a pass first type player. But he also is very active away from the ball, makes his cuts. And surprises you when he does go to finish, he's very good at it.
It's only 46% from the free throw line in the regular season. That looked a little like that. Coming into this game, 3 of 4 during the playoffs. McDonald's got problems again. Corletto to Dave Thomas. And the Tigers will set it up in their offense. Corletto to screen from Axel Dench, who rolls to the hoop. McDonald available off the window. He adds the two for his first points. Tigers by 3, a little over 2 minutes left, term number one. Their championship on the line here. As Bradtke fires over the top, a little too hard off the window, and Dave Thomas grabs rebound number 7 in the game. Brisbane have 8 rebounds as a team, giving an indication of how tough Dave Thomas has been. Corletto ambitiously and unsuccessfully with his first shot attempt. Now knocked over by McGill, no whistle forthcoming. Reichardt baseline, got a good look at it, and helps himself to another 2. He has 7 in the game, and only Tucker with 8 has more.
Good no call. I thought he wasn't really going out of control. Wasn't a big hit. Great pass to DT.
Lost control, Boucher falling to the floor. Loose ball scramble, Gibson scoops it up for Brisbane. Bradtke joining in, takes on Dave Thomas, wheeling and dealing. The big man goes to work unsuccessfully. Tip in wouldn't tumble either. He stays with it and retreats to Boucher, who works it to Mick Hill. He takes them on and is fouled by Axel Dench. And Mick Hill, who gets to the free throw line more than any other player for Brisbane, is going to the stripe once more.
It looks as if the Bullets are down in this series, as Mick Hill, after an offensive rebound that every single Brisbane Bullet on the floor seemed to get their hand on. They just seem to be the team that is getting to the loose balls a little bit better than the Tigers. Out quicking them, exploding up quicker on the offensive glass, just keeping that thing alive. I know the score is tied, but Brisbane are taking care of business here away from home.
Tigers have racked up 8 fouls here in the first term. The Bullets with 5 in that category. Brad Williamson checks into the match for the first time, replacing Dusty Reichardt. CJ Bruton and Sam McKinnon, the only starters on the floor for Brisbane at the moment. Likewise, the Tigers have 2 of their original 5, McDonald and Dave Thomas out there. Dench. Getting close attention from Bradtke, works it inside to Dave Thomas, who had a good seal on CJ Bruton. And Dave Thomas has been impressive so far. 6 points, 7 rebounds. Tigers by a point. Bruton gets Bradtke. A good look, but David Stiff shuts him down. The ball went down onto the baseline. Brisbane will get possession.
Tigers are swarmed, and no doubt about that, on the defensive end. 3 guys in the area. David Stiff goes straight up in the air.
3rd block in the match for Melbourne. Brisbane yet to get any action in that category.
His clock is straight out of court, okay? So shot clock shouldn't have reset.
The shot clock.
Yeah, so what have we got on there?
Was reset inadvertently.
I mean, they brought the ball in the floor, got it overly late. A couple of passes. I'm happy if it goes 10, all right? I don't know any, yeah, because it works with the logic, you're over an 8, a couple of passes, happy to go of 10 on that type of stuff, right? Unless you guys know anything better.
Well, Scott Butler, who this season won his 3rd consecutive referee of the year title in his grand final of the 8th straight year. The best referees in Australia, if not the best. Billy Mildenhall and Michael Aylin. The 3 that did game 3 are here for game 4, so that gives you an indication of the referees, commissioner's thoughts. Pat Tilden looks after the referees and obviously feels these are the best 3 men for this grand final series.
You know, nobody's perfect, but they don't miss calls because they're overwhelmed by the situation.
McKinnon penetrating, attracted plenty of attention. It left McGill available on the baseline, but he can't convert. Now the Tigers have an opportunity at the offensive end. McDonald gets it from Dave Thomas. Shot clock is going to be some 5 seconds inside the game clock.
9 on the shot clock.
9 seconds on the shot.
Melbourne 10 of 20 from the field so far at 50%. Brisbane 8 of 22 at 36. David Stiff was fouled as he rolled to the hoop, and he will go back to the free throw line. Brisbane are 5 of 9 from the stripe in the match so already. And the Tigers 2 of 2.
David Stiff, watch CJ just kind of hang on to him. Didn't see it, kind of blocked by another player. But those are the little things, if you're good at it. Like when a guy goes to reach with the ball, don't grab that hand. Grab the other arm that's he's going to try and bring to it to pull the ball up and have a shot. Get a closer look. Just grabbing that arm. See, trying to grab that arm so he can't reel the pass in, or he can't catch a clean one.
Good D from McKinnon, slapped it away from Axel Dench. And the Bullets with the last say here in the first term. McKinnon with a 3 ball, and he swishes another big shot. First quarter honors will go with the Brisbane Bullets as they take over right on quarter time. And it's Brisbane 24 leading Melbourne 22 here on Fox Sports. Bullets with a possession arrow as we get underway term number 2. And that shot on the buzzer from Sam McKinnon means the Melbourne Tigers in the last 6 quarters against Brisbane are yet to win one. They've only won 2 of the 13 so far. Bruton gets it off quickly but unsuccessfully, and Melbourne with numbers up the floor. Corletto working inside Stephen Black, who's already playing with 2 fouls, but Corletto couldn't complete it. May get another opportunity and retreats to Darryl McDonald. Dave David Stiff beyond his range. Hands over to McDonald. Now Tucker posting up Ebi Ura. Tucker's 4 of 5 from the field for his 8 points. Shut down by Ebi Ura. Excellent. Dean called for a traveling violation. Rashad Tucker.
I thought that Ebi got a piece of that. He blocked the shot. No. He just let it go. I thought he knocked the ball loose, but he didn't. Good call.
Ebi Ura takes it from CJ Brute. Single digits on the shot clock now for Brisbane. McKinnon upstairs throwing down the dunk. Emphatic work from the Brisbane Bullets, who have scored the last 5 points here to lead by 4. Tucker hands over to McDonald. He was looking inside for Axel Dench, but it's turnover number 7 for Melbourne. Brisbane have only 2 in that category. Stephen Black for the triple. Knocked down, taking the shot, but fills it up nonetheless. And the Bullets have exploded on an 8-0 run to lead by 7.
The Tigers are so shaky. Dribbling right to trap areas.
Dench working against Bradtke. Spins baseline, steps past him and adds the 2. First points in the match for Axel Dench.
That's so big. Axel Dench inside the paint. That's the steadier, but they needed a high percentage shot because the Bullets are starting to smell blood.
Stephen Black pulls up in front of David Stiff, fires unsuccessfully. Tucker with the rebound. Number 4 for him in that category. Here's David Stiff taking them on and drawing a foul. Willie Mildenhall supplies the whistle.
This nice dribble penetration after splitting the high ball screen. Ebi Ura delivers one to Sam McKinnon. And David Stiff has CJ Bruton moving underneath him. David Stiff, although he can make some turnovers, he's probably the most aggressive one against that pressure of the big men.
No one has more championships in the NBL than David Stiff. He and Larry Sengstock with 5 apiece, and it's going to be a big offseason for David Stiff. He's going to become a father for the first time. He and his beautiful partner, Cara, expecting their first child around Anzac Day.
If he wins another championship, will they change the name of the trophy?
Whistle supplied here by Scott Butler. Foul is called on Daryl Corletto. 7 Melbourne players have picked up a foul already in the match. Only used 9 in the match. Ebi Ura goes to Stephen Black, working on crossball. Back to Ebi Ura for the 3. Couldn't find the target. Stephen Hall cleans up. Gets it to Rashad Tucker. Stephen Hall yet to score in the match. Goes to Dench, who wants Tucker down low against Ebi Ura. It's been their high percentage play so far in the game, and Tucker obliges once more. He has 10 to lead all scorers. To a 2-point ball game, a little over 3 minutes played. Turn number 2, McKinnon to Riker. Against multiple defenders, he's patient and rewarded as he adds another 2. Corletto to Stephen Hall. Back to the top of the key. Crosswell looking to penetrate against Stephen Black. Needs help. Stephen Hall provides it. Fires the 3 unsuccessfully, and Ebi Ura grabs the rebound. Tigers getting nothing from deep at the moment. They're none of 3 from long range as Chris Anstey prepares to check back in for Melbourne. Almost 4 minutes done here in the second period. Stephen Black exploring off the dribble. Finds McKinnon lurking baseline. Loose ball spills to Stephen Black. Bruton thought about the 3. Now defers to the MVP. He can't convert. Corletto had it. Ebi Ura almost stole it away, but Corletto did a good job to reel it back in. Tucker. Against the shorter Stephen Black feeds Dench, who works inside Reichardt, over the top of CJ Bruton, and it tumbles for Axel Dench. Now Bruton off and running to get Reichardt an ice low catch, and an easy 2. Reichardt has 11 to take over as the high scorer.
That looked a little like Steve Nash in the NBA. C.J. Gruden pushing on a made basket. Terrible pass from Rashad Tucker.
Batted down by Stephen Black. McKinnon to Ebi Ara, who has Tucker to beat. And he's coughed it up under pressure. Tucker with Bruton on the retreat, looking for Crosswell. Knocked down Stephen Black as well. That goes unwhistled. Crosswell fires and brings the fans alive.
Big, big shot. Nathan Crosswell can shoot that thing if you give him enough time like that.
First three of the match for the Melbourne Tigers as Bruton fall away against Darryl Corletto, who was nothing but excellent.
Other than Rashad Tucker down on the block, the Tigers don't have anything like that. And Brisbane have about four guys that are capable of making something out of nothing like CJ just did.
Tucker against Ebi Ara. Now McKinnon takes over. Dench fires over Riker. And McKinnon grabs the rebound. Quick whistle from Scott Butler. Foul is going to be called. Ebi Ara being spoken to as well.
33. Something happened between Ebi Ara and Stephen Hoare. That was the last whistle.
Timeout called. 6:36 left here. Term number two. The Tigers down 1-2 in this best of five scenario. Let's go into the huddle with Al Westover.
The perimeter shot, I didn't have one guy go the offensive boards. Every time. Hit the boards and then get back. When we scored and they got a layup, I can't watch that. We score, light your ass, get back, get to somebody quick, fellas. We got to get some stops to that end. We need the pressure. You need the pressure. You need to be active. You got to get after it. That's a mindset. We get the boards, look to run. You got Chris in there now. Look for the low post game, especially if Hoagie's out. Look to go right at him. We got a Ballarat. We got King. Come on now. 1, 2, 3, tight.
Well, you can talk about we're going to be up and in, we're going to pressure the passer, we're going to take pressure up the court, but it's another thing to do it. Brisbane has been doing it all year long. They've got tremendous depth. They got all 10 guys who are quick and athletic and used to doing it and knowing their teammates are going to back them up if they get beaten as they overplay. You can't just switch it on like that and play a different style of game when you go from game three to game four.
Dylan Boucher will restart to C.J. Bruton. The Brisbane Bullets looking to build on a three-point advantage. Middle stages of the second term. Biggest margin we've seen in the match so far was a seven-point buffer for Brisbane earlier in this period as McKinnon takes on Rashad Tucker, elevates, forced into a tough shot off balance. Ball spills out of court, last touch by Stephen Hoare. And Brisbane will restart. Sam McKinnon does the honors. They let Stephen Black alone. It was a bad mistake, although they get the foul called on Dylan Boucher to the delight of the fans. It's the second on Brisbane in this period. Tigers catch a break there. Stephen Black left alone for a mid-range jumper.
And he go a whole week without missing one of those.
Dave Thomas has Boucher on the retreat. Stephen Hoare getting plenty of treatment from Stephen Black. Thomas fires unsuccessfully. And now Riker taking on Anstey, forcing away past and beyond Crosswell as well. Boucher from close range got the two after Rashad Tucker. Came down on the floor, suggesting that he slipped on a wet spot as he was trying to hustle back on D.
Still trying to get a hand on Dylan Boucher as he's on the floor. A couple of bad shots by the Melbourne Tigers. Quick trigger from the perimeter. And you don't mind them shooting shots from the perimeter, maybe a little ball movement. Get an open shot, but try and shake somebody off the dribble early in the offense with nobody on the offensive glass isn't the way the Tigers play.
Stephen Hoare hands over to Nathan Crosswell. Started by Stephen Black. Gets it back from Stephen Hoare. Now Anstey, double team. Hit Crosswell with the pass. He couldn't control it. And another costly turnover for the Melbourne Tigers. It's 9 turnovers to 3. And that hurts. Gibson, plenty to think about by Nathan Crosswell, but likes his chances, and that's why. He's now 2 of 2 from the field. Adam Gibson has 5 points in the game. Margin back to an equal game high 7.
I think we're expecting to see good defensive energy out of these young guys, but not hitting game crucial shots like that.
Anstey draws a foul. He will go to the free throw line for the first time in the match, and the Tigers need something at the moment.
And up and under. Chris Anstey gets the call that he wanted. They're getting their fair share of calls. I just don't know if they have enough weapons to keep pace with the Brisbane Bullets. You look on the floor right now, Dylan Boucher's had a couple of nice moves to the basket. He's always active on the defensive end, getting after loose balls. Dusty Reichardt's played well. Sam McKinnon's played well. Adam Gibson's played well. And Stephen Black and Ebi Arao come off of those screens and knock down some jumpers. They've got 5 dangerous guys on the floor with 5 dangerous guys waiting to come on the floor. And the Tigers, they're a good team. They're hanging in there. But you don't get the feeling that they've got 5 dangerous guys on the floor like Brisbane did.
Gibson takes on Darryl McDonald. A little over 5 minutes out from halftime. Stephen Black, guarded by Rashad Tucker. Single digits on the shot clock for the Brisbane Bullets. He needs help. Reichardt provides it. Just hung in the air to manufacture an excellent finish against good D from Chris Anstey. 13 in the match for Reichardt on 6 of 8 shooting. He leads all scorers, and it's an 8-point buffer in favor of the Brisbane Bullets. Anstey goes to work, and Reichardt came up with the excellent D, but Melbourne will get it back.
Now this is good defense. They get to Dusty, and he has to change his shot. This hangs up there a little bit longer and hits that little soft one-hand salamander.
Shot clock to 5 for Darryl McDonald as he takes on Stephen Black, and from close range, McDonald gets an extra 2 for the Melbourne Tigers.
Tigers need to come up with some stops. That's what Al Westover was talking about. We need some stops on this end of the floor.
Darryl McDonald doesn't like the call, and he's picked up his second personal. Foul on Melbourne in this period. Likewise, Brisbane has committed 3 fouls since quarter time. McHugh comes back, and Stephen Black will get a rest. 4 and a bit minutes to play until half time, and Dave Thomas collides with Mick Hill. Now Gibson. Double team gets it to Reichardt, who spins on Rashad Tucker. Reaching in, Tucker got a clean strip. Now Dave Thomas with Anstey joining in. Adam Gibson to beat. Dave Thomas shares it with McDonald, who measures the 3 ball, and that looks like the fans.
That's what Brisbane do. Double down, they kick out of it, a guy's wide open, they knock him down.
Adam Gibson penetrating, kicks to McKinnon. Guarded by Stephen Hoare, now picks up the dribble, needs help. Gibson outside to Ebi Arat, who is fouled by Rashad Tucker. 4th team foul on Melbourne in this turn.
One thing I do notice, as Ebi Arash shows and gets Rashad Tucker up in the air, he sticks his arm out. That's what he drew the contact. But Brisbane, after they have some contact, never complain. And Tigers seem to be bitching on just about every call.
Gibson bounces off Anstey, finds Mick Hill available. He shares it with McKinnon, his 3. Can't connect. Dave Thomas to Anstey, and now Rashad Tucker. Stephen Hoare ahead of him, gets it next. Good D from Mick Hill tonight, a passing lane initially for Dave Thomas, but he stayed with it, and DT gets his first points in the second period. Tigers have scored the last 7, their best run in the game. They've closed to within 1, but Adam Gibson has got other ideas.
He has been flawless in the last game and a half. Wow. Boy, his stock is just rising and rising.
Stephen Hall to McDonald, who looks at the shot clock. Now Anstey posting up McKinnon from close range. Anstey is now 3 of 4 from the field and has 7 points and 4 rebounds. It's a 2-point buffer. Reichardt just handled the pass from Sam McKinnon, and now Ebiara is fouled by Anstey. Free throws to come for the Nigerian international.
Tigers giving it their all, but Brisbane keep coming up with these loose balls. Ebiara, hang time. Chris Anstey has to pull that arm down.
Timeout called by the Melbourne Tigers. 2:21 out from the major break. It's a 2-point ball game with free throws to come for the Brisbane Bullets. The All-Star 5 for the 2007 NBL season has been announced, and it was no surprise to see Sam McKinnon poll more votes than anyone else. Chris Anstey picked up 90 votes. Sam McKinnon had 107. Chris Anstey, 90. Martin Catalini, 78 votes. Dave Thomas, 64. And Carlos Powell had 74 votes. Tremendous lineup. That would win you a few games, Steve.
Yeah, you know, I'm a guard. I think it's a little forward heavy, but I could probably deal with that.
Well, the next highest vote getter was Brad Newley with 62 votes. I was surprised that there was no John Riley in either the first, second or third NBL teams. He won 3 Player of the Week awards, more than anyone in the NBL. Came up with a number of match-winning displays, hit more threes than anyone in the competition. Did a hell of a good job for the Townsville Crocodiles as they moved all the way up to 5th spot. And if he wasn't in the best 15 players in the league, then I wasn't at any games this season.
You've been to plenty. And he's starting to be one of those players, John, really a good, solid player. Everybody's going crazy about all these athletic, young, long arm, you know, NBA type future players, and he's starting to kind of get lost in the mix. Not lost as far as player of the week and the respect of the players and the coaches around the league, but just he's not the flashy type of player. He'll get a triple double or close to it and won't even make a whole lot of noise.
Yes, he was one of only 3 players this season to come up with a triple double as McDonald goes exploring, wheeling and dealing. And T-Mac adds another 2 to the Melbourne Tigers' cause. He has 9, and only Tucker with 10 has more in the game for Melbourne. Inside the last 2 minutes of the first half, McDonald giving Gibson plenty to think about. The young man goes on with the job. This time Stephen Hall knocks down the pass. Tucker with Ebiara to beat. Finger rolls another 2, and we are tied at 46 as the fans get involved.
Look at this sweet drive by D-Mac. Has to finish over a 6'10 Mark Bradtke. Man, they've come up with some big plays.
McKinnon top of the key, guarded by Stephen Hall. Looks for some penetration, spinning to his favorite right-hand side. Ball grabbed by Anstey. Hands over to Darryl McDonald. Dave Thomas wanted it early, but Stephen Hall's available as well. He stops and pops and drills another 3. Melbourne have scored the last 7 to retake the lead.
You're not going to beat the Bullets, who are the favorite in this game, if you don't hit big shots. 3 huge shots by the Melbourne Tigers give them this 3-point lead.
Now Westover and the Tigers getting excited here. Their backs are against the wall. And trail by as many as 8 here. Brisbane down by 3. Get Mick Hill involved. Now Ebiara with 10 on the shot clock. Firing over the top of Rashad Tucker. Can't convert it. Anstey and Bradtke wrestling. The ball spills to Darryl McDonald.
Stay on the page.
Dave Thomas to Hall. Now Darryl McDonald with the shot clock at 10. He finds Dave Thomas just inside the 3-point line. Tucker, the offensive rebound over the back of CJ Bruton. Anstey measures the 3. Yes! Good things are happening for the Melbourne Tigers. A 10-0 run, the best in the game so far, in the shadows of halftime. Bruton
fires the triple for Brisbane and comes up with a major shot for the Bullets. And that's why he's been the most successful player in the NBL in the last 4 years. Brisbane have a foul to give and Mick Hill obliges. 8 seconds left until halftime. Anstey back to Darryl McDonald, who works down low. Was fouled by Mark Bradtke with the foot. So free throws to come for Darryl McDonald with 2.7 seconds left on the clock until halftime. Brisbane 7 of 11 from the free throw line. Melbourne 4 of 8 so far tonight. Mark Bradtke a little nonplussed as he picks up his first personal. 7 Brisbane players have committed a foul in the game. And 8 Melbourne players are in that category. McDonald overcorrects, gets it back though on the halftime buzzer. He fires unsuccessfully, but at the major break, the Melbourne Tigers have their noses in front. At halftime from the cage reads Melbourne 52, Brisbane 49 here on Fox Sports. Welcome back to Fox Sports, exclusively live coverage of the NBL Grand Final, Game 4. The Melbourne Tigers lead it by 3. Lindsay Gase and Margaret, his wife, in their familiar seats here behind the Melbourne Tigers bench, hoping that this is going to remain on the same flight path in terms of the Melbourne Tigers holding the lead for the second half here. Anstey takes the shot, but a foul is going to be called on Dave Thomas, an offensive foul, as he impeded the progress of Sam McKinnon. Not the start the Tigers were looking for. Bruton hands over to Ebiarad. Now Stephen Black is being quiet. Just one field goal in the first half for Stephen Black. Reichardt hard to the hoop, off the window. Steps by Stephen Hort to add another 2. He has 15. And the game high scorer, Dave Thomas, in traffic. Goes to Anstey. They have numbers up the floor. It's McDonald. Works on Stephen Black. Wants to back his way in closer. Dave Thomas uses Tucker against Ebiarad. Inside looking for Stephen Hoare, who somehow reeled in the pass, but now Anstey won't be able to control that, and the shot clock will expire on the Melbourne Tigers. An offensive foul, and then a turnover to start the second half. Our Westover is not feeling too good at the moment.
No, not at all. 2 possessions and no shot attempts here in the first half, second half for the Tigers.
C.J. Group resumes his battle with Darryl McDonald. Now Reichardt to McKinnon. Shut down by good D from Dave Thomas. Stephen Black shakes Anstey. Fires over Stephen Hoare and fills it up. The Bullets have scored the last 7 to retake the lead.
Those are tough shots. And that's what Brisbane do. They have the ability to make tough shots and get the defensive play. Stephen Black comes up with the turnover.
Stripped McDonald off the ball. The Melbourne Tigers 12 turnovers to 4. Reichardt firing over McDonald, rattles around the rim and tumbles for Dusty Reichardt. Brisbane have their best run in the game. It's a 9-zip run. They lead by 3. Tucker gets it to Stephen Hall. Whistle provided by Scott Butler. Foul called on Dusty Reichardt. It's his first.
3 straight turnovers for the Tigers. Let's see if they can get a shot up.
Anstey to Darryl McDonald. Down low, Stephen Hoare. Works inside Reichardt. McDonald top of the key, measuring the triple. Couldn't complete it. Tucker had a piece of it. And Dave Thomas somehow manufactured it off the window to tumble.
Sometimes you need a little luck. They get the home court roll.
Snaps a 9-0 run. Brisbane with a 1-point lead and 10 on the shot clock as Stephen Black gets it from Ebiarad, firing over Tucker. Stephen Black warming up now.
That's the amazing thing. He's got the energy to pull off plays like that. And Stephen Black will get called for that foul. The energy to make shots and stay up and in. And we'll watch this tip by Dave Thomas. Somehow he gets that thing up. And that was off Sam McKinnon. He just guided his hand in that direction. And this is Stephen Black.
Stephen Black now with three fouls. No one has more in the match. McKinnon wrestling with Anstey. Another whistle provided by Scott Butler, and McKinnon picks up the foul. That's three on Brisbane in this turn.
I'm starting to think that's about the only way the Tigers can stop Brisbane. Get some key players into foul trouble.
McDonald retreats to Dave Thomas. Almost 3 minutes played, term number three. Tigers outscored 8 points to two. Make that 8-4. As McDonald gets into double figures. Ebiara takes on Tucker, whose second effort was a good one. But Brisbane will maintain possession.
That's a break for them. He was beat.
Bruton restarts to Stephen Black, but he couldn't handle the pass, and Brisbane turned it over for the fifth time.
Well, Stephen Black was curl cutting, and CJ thought he was fading out to the wing.
Dave Thomas goes back to Darryl McDonald. 3 minutes done since halftime. Anstey, lob pass for DT. Had CJ Bruton in an awkward situation, and Dave Thomas adds another two. Melbourne retake the lead.
And that was about the first time all game Brisbane allowed the Tigers just to dribble the basketball up slow and freely.
Stephen Black puts it on the floor against Darryl McDonald, overcooked it. Anstey grabs the rebound. Outlet pass to Tucker. Dave Thomas working hard for him. McKinnon to beat. Contact and an offensive foul is called on Rashad Tucker, his third personal.
Rashad Tucker trying to be aggressive, but they know he likes to make this move and cut towards the middle. And Sam McKinnon, you don't have to take a charge in the middle of your chest, and it helps if the player is a little out of control. Still the toughest call in basketball to make.
Bruton getting a screen from Dusty Reichert. Goes back for seconds, looking inside. The pass a little off the money, and Melbourne have got it back again. They'll look for a percentage play. Stephen Hall, top of the key, goes to McDonald. Anstey posting up McKinnon with single coverage. 10 on the shot clock now for the Tigers. Anstey looking for Tucker. He was casual, trying to reel in the pass. And the Tigers cough it up again. That's five turnovers in 4 minutes since halftime. Fortunately for Melbourne, Brisbane have committed two turnovers of their own. Somehow Melbourne hold a one-point lead. Shot clock to 10 for the Bullets. Poor pass from Bruton, picked off easily by Stephen Hoare. That was a poor pass for Dave Thomas. There was no room for it, no angle on it. And Stephen Hoare, just one of three from the field. I'm not sure if he's playing injured, but they're not getting what they would expect out of Stephen Hoare.
Miles is going to go crazy in this timeout. Come out there after you speak at halftime about the things that you want to do, executing and going to another level.
All on the first pass. Hey, if it's not there, make some decisions, fellas. Get it out. It's trans. We go low. Get it out. We're high. You probably won't get right to the rim on that. The LA's on, but you keep running wide. Right to the top of the key. You're behind the ball. Once he's advancing, get your ass to the top of the key. Then maybe we'll get into it. But fellas, it's decisions. It's decisions. When we take care of it and get in there, it seems so easy. If it's not there early, you gotta make some decisions. Those are blood rushes. Settle down a little bit. So we're trans. It's LA for you. But you got your version. Hey, 31 pick. 31 pick.
Like you said, Case. They have been let off the hook because all those turnovers that they've made, still having a one-point lead, is explosive. And as much of the opportunists that Brisbane are, normally you make a couple of mistakes, they're kind of closing the door shut on the game. So they do have some life. They've caught a break by that.
Brisbane 4 of 5 from the field since halftime. Melbourne Tigers 3-5. A host of turnovers as McKinnon restarts to CJ Bruton. Evie Arap. Only 2 points in the game, and that's from the foul line for Evie Arap. You know, he's not too far away from knocking down a shot. Dave Thomas almost stole the pass. Stephen Black reeled it in and then fired from deep. Can't convert. Rashad Tucker grabs the rebound. Number 7 for Tucker in that category. And only Dave Thomas with 9 has more. The rebound count 31-16. Tigers have doubled almost what Brisbane have come up with off the boards. And now whistle off the ball. Dusty Riker picks up his second, and it's the fourth team foul on Brisbane in this turn. Only 5 minutes played in this term and 4 fouls for Brisbane. They rack up more fouls than any other team in the NBL. Average 26 per game. In contrast, the Tigers, the lowest fouling team in the NBL. McKinnon works at the Bruton. Now Stephen Black onwards to Dusty Riker. Low scoring third term. Brisbane lead at 8-6 so far in 5.5 minutes. McKinnon stepped back off the money. Loose ball, Tigers after it. And have numbers. McDonald lost it. Almost stepped out of court as well. Stephen Hoare to Anstey. Single coverage from Sam McKinnon. He's the best defender. Evie Arar came across with a help D. Stephen Hoare kept it alive for Melbourne. Again, looking for a passing lane that wasn't there. It's knocked down by CJ Bruton. Evie Arar has Dave Thomas to beat and comes up with his first field goal in the match to put Brisbane back in front.
And now Westover just told him, if it's not there, don't do it. And 2 turnovers on that possession.
Tucker looking for the penetration. Dicks to McDonald. 10 on the shot clock for the Tigers. Dave Thomas with the 3 ball. Off the front of the rim. McKinnon falling out of court. Kept it alive to Evie Arar. As Stephen Black and Reichert now available from close range. And the Brisbane Bullets add another 2. They lead it by 3. McDonald took 7 of the 8 seconds to get over the halfway line. Now Stephen Hoare, who's well overdue, knocks down the triple. The tie away at 61. Joey Wright looking as though he's going to bring in platoon substitutions here. 4 Bullets players getting ready to check in. Reichert from close range adds another 2. The Brisbane Bullets put their noses back in front. Reichardt's 21 is the game high score. He's the only Brisbane player in double figures. Reichardt looking for Dave Thomas. Tigers trying desperately hard to turn it over. There's Sam McKinnon grabbing the rebound. Brisbane by 2. Stephen Black reels in the pass. Bruton bounces into Darryl McDonald.
It's a normal foul. It's a normal.
See,
just walk away. A normal foul.
CJ Bruton thought it was a little untoward, the foul.
Have you got anything after that? All right. Hang on, boys. 44. Push on the floor.
Douglas on the ground.
Guys, side ball here.
I don't understand what all the fuss is about. Got him up in the air, drew the foul.
Darryl McDonald goes to the bench. He has 11 points. One of 4 Melbourne players in double figures. Well, it's been a solo display from Dusty Riker with 21 that has dominated the scoring, and now all 10 Brisbane players are on the score sheet as Brad Williamson opens his account. Is 4 in favour of Brisbane. A little over 4 minutes to play in this third term, and worrying signs for the Melbourne Tigers. Dave Thomas needs help. Anstey provides it. His 3 is short on the rim. Tucker, the offensive rebound. Anstey works inside. Bradtke takes them all on, knocks down the two and draws a foul, and the fans finally have something to cheer about.
It ain't pretty, is it? The Melbourne Tigers offense is far from pretty, but somehow they managed to put the ball in the basket when they needed the most. Chris Anstey with a floater that goes in. Crowd desperate to cheer about something. They've just been hit with an array of turnovers here in the second half. Chance to draw to one.
The free throw shooting has been woeful as well. Tigers 5 of 11, Brisbane 7 of 11. 1-point ball game, less than 4 minutes out from three-quarter time. Bullets edging closer to their first title in 20 years as Ebi Arafai is unsuccessfully. Dave Thomas grabs the rebound. Number 10 for him in that category, which he leads the game. David Stiff discombobulated the Brisbane D and adds the two.
There's another one of those. I'm shaking my head on Dave Stiff's move. It was just unorthodox but effective.
He's put the Tigers back in front on the back of a 5-0 run. Ebi Arafai draws David Stiff out of the paint. Now Gibson pushes away David Stiff. Boucher baseline, running out of room, knocked over Anstey. It went unwhistled. Shot clock expires. It was after the event, and we're going to the scoring bench here.
I can't hear a thing.
I thought it was after the event. Let's get another look at it.
Then he got stripped.
I looked at the shot clock in the distance, and it expired. Good call. Good call.
Tigers with only two starters on the floor at the moment as Corletto edges over the halfway line and draws a foul on the Brisbane Bullets. Free throws to come for the best foul shooter on the Tigers lineup, Darryl Corletto.
Let's get another look at that shot clock situation. He lets it go, then it go. It's expired now, so he still has it in his hand. It's a very good call by the bench. And again, not much fuss on the other end for Brisbane. They are just taking care of business.
Darryl Corletto gets his first score in the game. Tigers now with 9 on the score sheet, Brisbane all 10. Can't make the back end though. Melbourne with a 2-point lead. They started this period with a 3-point buffer. Ebi Arafai. Double team. Boucher behind the back to Bradtke, lurking on the baseline. Draws a foul on Axel Dench. Fourth team foul on Melbourne. Free throws to come for Mark Bradtke. Who's one of two from the free throw line so far tonight. His wife, Nicole, is in the house.
Mark Bradtke to the line to shoot two shots.
Maybe she's feeling a little nervous. His free throw shooting isn't the best, but generally speaking, when it's an important free throw, Mark Bradtke will hit them. Can't get the back end. Adam Gibson keeps it alive for the Bullets, though, and Ebi Arafai fires the triple off the money. Now Williamson's got it back for Brisbane. They are relentless, the Bullets. And Adam Gibson, feeling confident, skims one over the rim. Ebi Arafai, the offensive rebound and the putback. Brisbane retake the lead. Quickly up the floor, Dave Thomas takes on multiple defenders. Dylan Boucher worried him out of the points. And the Bullets off and running again. Ebi Arafai gets good Z from David Stiff, goes on with the job. Now he's lost control. Bradtke reels it in and is fouled by Darryl Corletto. Bradtke back to the free throw line.
It was ugly. Good hustle, though. As Ebi Arafai, the ball knocked away from him. And Darryl Corletto gets in on the hands of Mark Bradtke. Another ugly possession. This is when you start to see the desperation of this game. Brisbane see this baby as an opportunity to take it out tonight. They've played like that the entire night. They've been the aggressor. And the Tigers, with the experience that they have, managed to stay in the game.
Line, fellas.
And Joey Wright would know, even though they look to have been the better team throughout the series, that is no guarantee going into game five. He wants this thing tonight.
Ebiora sits down, replaced by C.J. Bruden. A little over 2 minutes to play, term number three. Brisbane have scored the last 5 points. Again, Melbourne struggling to get the ball over the halfway line. Dave Thomas, the only starter on the floor for Melbourne at the moment. Here he is. He was available. David Stiff then coughed up the pass to Brad Williamson. Gibson goes to Williamson, gets it back. Bruton from the three-point line fires off the front of the rim. Bradtke in over the back of David Stiff. Melbourne will get possession. The timeout called. 1:39 left on the clock. Joey Wright's enjoying the contest at the moment. The Bullets with a three-point buffer. Looking strong, and the challenge is for the Melbourne Tigers to find a way to get this done.
Every stop we get, they're going to tighten up. Every single stop. We're boarding down here, fellas. It's not going to be offensive board. It's not pretty offensive, but it's working. Keep going. Just grind them out. Keep going. Hey, stay cold. Stay catching
it. Sign up. All right, two right here, all right? Two coming out of this. Two. All right? As soon as we get in, hustle and get into the two. We'll try to break this play right here.
Take us on that pass. Yeah, take us on the pass.
Two to Texas right here. If they go to the left side of the court, they're first. Yeah, on the reversal, we're Texas. If they go to the right side, as he cuts through, then we're in Texas right there.
Composed huddle for the Brisbane Bullets. They've outscored Melbourne 21-15 since halftime. Lead by three. Coming from behind in a grand final is a difficult scenario for anyone. Biggest comeback we've ever seen in grand final history at three-quarter time is just 6 points. David Stiff needs help. Dedge provides it. Harassed by Bradtke. Croswell down to Stiff. 10 on the shot clock as he looks to take on Dylan Boucher. Now he needs support. Dedge with 4 on the shot clock works down low. Bradtke rejected the shot. Dench throws up a prayer, and the shot clock expires in the background.
I thought when he caught the ball, he should have shot it. He had an open look from the three-point line, put it on the floor, and had to shoot one over the back of the backboard.
Well, as we heard from the Brisbane huddle, each time Melbourne come up empty, they tighten up a little more. Williamson dribbling in traffic. Inside the last 60 seconds, term number three. C.J. Bruton takes on Croswell. Can't complete it. Dave Thomas falling out of court. Dumped the ball down, and Brisbane are there to retrieve it. Bruton for the triple.
Boy, this game is at a crucial situation. Tigers desperately need a bucket here and a stop. Brisbane, by that timeout, they're smiling and grinning. Felt like they've got the Tigers on the ropes.
6-point lead as Dave Thomas steps back. Couldn't complete it. Dylan Boucher gets after the rebound. Adam Gibson, with no teammates ahead of him, will slow it down. Shot clock 2 seconds inside the game clock. There is no hurry here, but C.J. Bruton leads them a merry dance, gets the two, draws a foul, and the Brisbane Bullets are making a statement right now.
Bad shot by Dave Thomas early in the offense. Nothing, just put it on the floor and tried to create something. No offensive rebounders. That's a hell of a finish by C.J. Bruton.
Makes the extra from the free throw line. The Brisbane Bullets have the biggest lead we've seen at any stage in the match, and the best run of the game as well. They've scored the last 11. Melbourne desperate for a big play here on the three-quarter time buzzer. Croswell to Dench for the triple. Couldn't buy it. Gibson will get it off from three-quarter court unsuccessfully, but with one quarter to play, Brisbane can sniff the championship. They lead it by 9. It's Brisbane 76, Melbourne 67 here on Fox Sports.
Brisbane with a possession arrow on a 9-point lead. The Melbourne Tigers are going to have to create NBL Grand Final history to keep their championship hopes alive. No team has come from this far down with a quarter to play and survived. Bruton getting plenty of treatment. Boucher was in the paint for a long time and then got it a little too hard. Williamson keeps it alive for the Bullets. They are everywhere at the moment. Adam Gibson can't complete the three. McDonald grabs the rebound. Not appreciating the contact from Brad Williamson. Brisbane start the final term with just one starter on the floor. Here's McDonald penetrating, going solo, adding the two. He now has 13 points. Joins Chris Anstey as Melbourne's high scorer.
Nine isn't a ridiculous number to come back from, but it is important to have a good start. Nothing like the third quarter when they started so poorly. C.J. Bruton for three has one rattle out.
Tigers with another opportunity here. McDonald slows it down. Stephen Hoare to Dench, drawing Bradtke out of the middle. Whistle off the ball. Tucker draws a foul on Brad Williamson. Chris Anstey joins us from the Tigers bench. And Chris, you said pre-game it was do or die. It's looking like a difficult situation at the moment.
Yeah, those last 3 minutes of the third quarter certainly has helped us. And, you know, we've put ourselves in a bit of a hole. But, you know, we just got to put it all on the line now. And if we're going to go down, we've got to go down swinging.
Chris, you're out shooting the Bullets 51% to 45. You're pounding them on the rebound count. Why are they controlling the match at the moment?
I think we've turned the ball over too much. You know, there's not many stats that matter tonight except for the final score, so we've got to take care of that. I don't think the others really matter too much.
And I'm surprised that you've sat down a lot in this match. I thought you might be out there for the entire game. Is there any reason behind that?
No, just our usual rotation, so hopefully I'll be out there in a minute.
Appreciate your time. Hang in there. Anstey about to check into the game. Bruton leading them a merry dance. Gets Sam McKinnon an open layup. He adds the two, and the margin again is back to nine.
Brisbane aren't going to go on a drought. They're going to put numbers on the board. So you got to be able to convert on those shots like D-Mac had one trickle off the back of the rim. Tough pass.
Stephen Hall was looking for Tucker's support, cut out by Adam Gibson. Here's McHill dishing into McKinnon for the dunk, and the Brisbane Bullets climb their way to a double-figure lead for the first time in the game. Fans are stunned here at the cage. Tigers down by 11. McDonald called for the offensive foul. It's Adam Gibson doing the defensive job again.
Well, that's what happens when you wait till 12 seconds on the shot clock to get it going. Adam Gibson chesting up, reaching in, goes to turn the corner. A little bit of an extended arm gets him the call. I thought it was soft, but especially in this stage of the game, but you got to live with that.
McKinnon, guarded by Stephen Hall, looks inside for Bradtke, working against Anstey. Shot clock down to single digits as McKinnon fires over Stephen Hoare. Did an excellent defensive job to deflect the shot. And now Tucker to McDonald. Guarded by McHill, Rashad Tucker. Trying to find an opening. Here's Anstey in a mismatch against McHill. He'll want to back his way in close, and the double team arrives from Bradtke. Outside Corletto for the three. Yes!
They have to knock down every open shot, and they cannot allow any offensive rebounds.
C.J. Bruton works inside McDonald, then short-armed it. Stephen Hoare can't keep it alive, and Brisbane will get it back with 14 on the shot clock. Timeout called, 8:39 left on the clock. The Brisbane Bullets with an 8-point buffer and a 2-1 lead in our best of five series. Closing in on the title. Let's go in with our West over.
Well, pressure on the ball. Well, they do that high screen, good show laterally. You wing guys got to be active. You got to be active as soon as he picks it up or makes a pass. Get back quickly there. Be aware of Sammy coming underneath on that. make sure you block out. We board, look to run. If it's not there, high post. Either circle or into our step or first push. We got the post or we got the spider off of that. Fellas, we don't need a panic here. Couple stops, couple good times on offense. We eliminate the turnovers, get good shots, we'll be in good shape. Keep playing, keep playing.
Well, this is our 12th game in 24 days here in the NBL, but if it's not enough for you, maybe you want to stick around, because straight after this, we'll see if the Orlando Magic can clean up the Chicago Bulls from Amway Arena in Orlando, coming up straight after the decision here between Brisbane and Melbourne. Well, it's looking confident, and why not? They've dominated the grand final series. Melbourne Tigers have won just three quarters. And they'll need to win this one here big if they're going to force a deciding game five. Off the window, Sam McKinnon adds another two. He's been busy in this final period. He has all six of the Bullets' points. Margin is 10. A little over 8 minutes to play. Tucker looks to penetrate against Mick Gill. Now shut down. Anstey gets a look at the three. Can't complete it. Tucker needed to do better from close range and couldn't get enough on the shot. Brisbane with an opportunity to expand their buffer. Bruton fires. He's short on the rim. Gets his own rebound. Adds another two.
Little things starting to break down for the Tigers. Daryl McDonald didn't screen out after CJ elevated for the first J.
Biggest lead we've seen in the game. Melbourne Tigers desperate for a score, but come up empty once again. McDonald wins it back for the Tigers. Now they've got numbers. They're queuing up around the perimeter. Corletto.
This thing's far from over. Hit some shots, get it down to about five, and then it's a lot different when guys are pulling up and trying to get a score on Brisbane's end of the floor.
Mick Gill penetrating, kicks to Bradtke from close range, cannot make the shot. He's now none of four from the field, Mark Bradtke. And Melbourne breathe again. Tucker posting up Stephen Black, who's playing with three fouls. He steps between a couple of defenders, beats Corletto. He knocks down another three.
Perfect time to come alive from the three-point line. Two big threes by Daryl Corletto. Excellent passing by the Tigers.
6 point ball game. CJ Bruton takes on McDonald. Tough shot, but off the window. He's equal to the challenge. What a play from CJ Bruton. He and McKinnon, between them, have come up with all 10 of Brisbane's points since three quarter time. Corletto again firing. This time, quartered a little deep. Brisbane will look to build on an 8 point edge. Had the better of Daryl McDonald. Now Stephen Black with single digits on the shot clock. He looks to penetrate with a non-preferred right hand. Stephen Black adds the two.
Shot makers. Brisbane's got a boatload of them. Sam McKinnon, Stephen Black, CJ Bruton doing the damage here at the end of the fourth.
Anstey restricted to 13 points in the match so far. Single digits on the shot clock for McDonald, who's double team, forced into a tough one down on the baseline. McKinnon grabs the rebound. Stephen Black has Mick Hill in support, joining in CJ Bruton. Now they get it to Mick Hill in the corner. He's fouled by Anstey, taking the three. That was a brutal foul from Chris Anstey. There wasn't a lot of science there.
Frustration foul. Just cleans him up. Boy, this is, if the Tigers come back and get this one, this will be like the Sydney, West Sydney game five, where Sydney looked dead in the water. That is exactly where the Tigers look right now. Big giant boat, no paddles.
Long faces on the bench as well as Mick Hill knocks down the first two. Of
his family and friends, the former Dandenong Junior, can't connect on the back end. But it's a 12-point lead with 5.5 minutes to play, and the Tigers, the reigning champs, are hanging by a thread. Anstey, top of the key, draws a foul on Stephen Black. That will be his fourth, second team foul on Brisbane in this turn.
Surprise, Stephen Black left Daryl Corletto. He's wide open if that wasn't a foul. He's the only guy doing damage.
This is Crosswell. Now Dave Thomas trying to shake Mick Hill, getting a screen from Anstey. Down low, Stephen Hoare has been largely ineffective tonight, and the foul is going to be called on the Brisbane Bullets. Sam McKinnon in the vicinity looking a little nonplussed at the moment. He now has three.
I can see why. He just lost his balance.
Is Corletto going to work from close range? Needed a second wide at it, but got the job done. He has been important here in the final term. He has 11 of Melbourne's 13. Solo effort from Daryl Corletto. Still Brisbane prevail at the moment by double figures. Anstey grabs the rebound, and a foul is going to be called on the Bullets as well. Mick Hill takes another one to the chops.
Their pressure is just unbelievable. The Tigers can't grab a rebound. Watch this. Anstey no doubt has the rebound, but two guys swarming all over him. It's an unfortunate one for Mick Hill, but their pressure doesn't allow the Tigers to do anything without possibly losing the ball. Just like that.
Yeah, boy.
Substitutions coming from Brisbane as Reichardt and CJ Bruton check in. Mick Hill will sit down along with Stephen Black. Bullets have committed four fouls in this term. They need to be careful. Next one will send the Tigers to the free throw line as Anstey looks down for Crosswell. Didn't handle the pass initially. Now Anstey gets a look at the three. Can't convert. Anstey now one of four from long range, and Brisbane with all the answers. Al Westover calling on Rashad Tucker and Daryl McDonald to check back in. As Bruton fires over the top of Corletto, helps himself to another three.
It's almost as if Brisbane are toying with the Tigers. CJ Bruton picking now to come alive from the perimeter.
13-point lead, biggest in the game. Four and a bit minutes to play. Tucker and McDonald check back in. Corletto, an excellent job, goes to the bench with Nathan Crosswell. And the Tigers with one last roll of the dice here. McDonald on a nice pass from Chris Anstey, adds another two. He has 15 points in the match. The Tigers need something at the defensive end. Bruton's leading them a merry dance at the moment. Can't convert on this occasion. Tucker grabs the rebound, number 11 for him in that category. Mick Hill on the Brisbane bench at the moment. It's all going according to plan so far, Mick. You can see the finish line.
Yeah, we can smell it now. It's, you know, what, we're up by 11. We're just going to get some more stops. We knew if we pressured them the whole game and just played smart D, we knew they'd wear down, and that's what's happened so far. We're just going to be smart from now on.
When you guys talk about pressure, and not just pressure in the ball handler, but, I mean, that last one when you took one in the chops from Chris Anstey, you had two guys all over him, and he just pulled down a rebound.
Well, I guess, you know, when you're 3 minutes away from winning a championship, you'll do anything to get it. And, yeah, look, the guys have hustled all year. And we knew if we played like that tonight, we'd have a great chance of getting a W on a really tough home court for the Tigers.
Mick, you had the idea that this was a destiny thing for the Brisbane Bullets. You were talking a long way out from the grand final that you thought this was Brisbane's year. Why was that?
Just the camaraderie. I've never been on a team that gets along so well on and off the court. Everyone's on the same page. And, yeah, we said at the start of the year, if we can all give up part of our game to help us win, we'll do it. And that's what everyone's done.
It has been sacrificed by multiple players as well, hasn't it?
Of course. I mean, everyone from, you know, Hoagie. I mean, look at a guy who's played in four Olympics, won two championships, and he loves coming off the bench. I mean, what other big guy can do that?
We appreciate your time, Mick.
Thanks, guys.
Mick Hill, a live in-game interview here on Fox Sports. 3.5 minutes to play. The Bullets have coughed it up. There's still some work to do. Melbourne within 9 points. Score on this play phase. Just put a little more pressure back on Brisbane. 17 points apiece in this term. McDonald stripped of it by Sam McKinnon. That's 7 steals in the game for Brisbane. Only 3 for the Melbourne Tigers. And patiently, CJ Bruton is going to draw this out. Bradtke to McKinnon. Working on Tucker. Trying to find room for the shot. It was a tough one. Couldn't complete it. And Brisbane will get possession with 5 on the shot clock.
Crowd didn't like it, but everybody on the court knew that a Tiger had tipped that thing.
Right guard losing the ball down onto his foot, and Brisbane turn it over once more. That's 11 turnovers for Brisbane, but 23 has grilled Melbourne's chances tonight. Tucker taking him on. Reichardt called for the foul. It's his 3rd. Free throws to come for Rashad Tucker for the first time in the game, and he is not, generally speaking, a reliable conveyance from the free throw line.
Still a lot of time on the clock. That's just 3 shots. I know it's 3 three-point shots, and something that the Tigers haven't made a whole lot of, and their 3-point shot maker is on the bench in Daryl Corletto. But Brisbane have to continue to be aggressive on the other end, get some scores, close this thing out. Not that I have any doubt in my mind that they will. They won't be tentative. They might miss some shots, but they will not be tentative.
Nasty trying to tip in without success. Tucker all over McKinnon, took it away from him. From close range, Stephen Hall can't convert. Tigers blowing golden opportunities as Dave Thomas looks to get involved. Four to McDonald. He's finding Tucker down low, and eventually they get it to tumble. Pressure on CJ Bruton. He gets over the halfway line intelligently, but now in a double team situation, and a double dribble is being called by Scott Butler.
Great feed into Rashad Tucker, and then the defense by the Tigers, it's desperate. Stephen Hoare wiping that basketball off. They need that thing in perfect mint condition.
2:26 to play. 2 shots separate these teams. Melbourne down by as many as 13, have scored the last 7 points here. Dave Thomas double team. Anstey gets it from Stephen Hoare, works on Bradtke. Wraparound pass was never on. CJ Bruton grabs it for the Brisbane Bullets.
Still plenty of time, even with that turnover, plenty of time for the Tigers. But they need stops, and that's a difficult thing to do with this man, CJ Bruton.
Less than 2 minutes to play. Bradtke, the former Tiger, gets Brisbane a big play.
We said early in the series he looked super comfortable in this situation.
And that was his first field goal after missing his first 4 shots. Tucker was bumped by Ebiura. Tucker will go to the free throw line.
How big was that shot by Mark Bradtke? Never hesitated, caught that thing in rhythm, was open, and knocked it down.
Timeout called by the Melbourne Tigers.
The big fella stepping up as he has done so many times in this building.
Eight-point ball game. Here's Al Westover.
Well, yeah, get up and in, play the lanes, have good pressure on the ball. We get it. It's transition every time. Transition every time. Get into the post, or we got our yellow option. If we do a yellow, if we do a yellow when the feeder go down, screen the offensive one coming up. Yeah, then open up. Well, might get you on that, all right? So we got all trans, not on early. We look for the yellow. If we have to foul, the people you want to foul are Bradtke or Sammy. Sammy preferably. Bradtke or Sammy, go for the ball. Go for the ball. And Evie, all right, we have to foul. You don't want to foul Bradtke.
Come on,
Big shot again by Mark Bradtke. Man. It's things that ate. Al spoke about the hole that they dug right before or right at the end of the third quarter. Tough to reel these guys in. The confidence that they play with, the Brisbane Bullets. Once you give them a sizable lead, they're looking to blow you out. They're not looking to squander a lead.
Rashad Tucker, the high scorer for the Melbourne Tigers. He also has 11 rebounds, and no one has more in that category. And it's a six-point ball game once more. A little over 90 seconds to play. CJ Bruton, 7 points in this final term. After having 13 in the first three quarters. Here he is taking on a good defender in Dave Thomas. Ambiara for the icing. Couldn't get it to fall. Tucker grabs rebound number 12. And the Tigers with another opportunity. Tucker takes on Ambiara, beats Dave Thomas baseline. Can't get it to fall. Stephen Hall had a piece of it. McKinnon now off to Stephen Black. Ambiara in support. Asked him to do him any favors. He can't complete it. Stephen Black is fouled by Rashad Tucker. And Stephen Black will go to the free throw line.
You need everything to go your way. A wide open look. Dave Thomas wasn't able to knock it down. Stephen Black just missing that tip. Rashad Tucker a little frustrated on that one, but he has had one hell of a game.
Stephen Black to the free throw line. He was third best from the stripe in the regular season at 87%. Won a championship in 2000 with the Wildcats when his dad, Alan, was coaching. And less than 60 seconds to play. Brisbane lead by 8. I can hear the fans in Queensland stomping their feet right now. The Tigers must score on this play phase. McDonald quickly up the floor. Anstey for the long range three. Keeps their hopes alive. Next foul from Melbourne will send Brisbane to the free throw line. CJ Bruton's hoping that'll be the case. Here's Gibson. Retreating back to CJ Bruton. Tucker obliges and picks up his fifth personal. They needed to foul Mark Bradtke when he had the ball. Or Adam Gibson, but CJ Bruton and Stephen Black were the two that they didn't want to foul. CJ, as he's done all season, has picked it up when he's had to. Happy to take a backseat role and just quarterback the team. If everything is working the way they want. But in the final term, Bruton now has 8 points. Joins Reichardt now with 21 as the high scorer in the game.
Once they got their feet in the series, maybe the exception of that third quarter, 39 points by the Tigers, they have looked in full command of this series.
30 seconds to play. McDonald draws a foul on CJ Bruton, his third, and Darryl McDonald will go to the stripe where he is none of two so far in the game.
He can make these free throws, get that thing back down to 5. Brisbane have to make free throws to close it out. And you can believe that Mark Bradtke and Sam McKinnon are the guys that they'll want to target. That's what they mentioned in the timeout. But they'll have Stephen Black and CJ Bruton handling that thing. They're going to put a strong denial all over those two guys.
Five-point ball game it is. 30 seconds to play. Brisbane with possession. Gibson foul. He will go to the free throw line where he is one of two so far in the match.
He's a good foul shooter, but I guess when you look at your choices, plus he was the first one that got the ball too, they had to foul him. It wasn't like they were targeting. 28.2. The youngster from Tasmania. But his nerves have been rock solid all grand final.
Very mature display from the 20-year-old. Had a career-high 25 points against Singapore back on the 6th of January. Has his own fan club now as well. In that match, he was 9 of 11 from the field. Now Westover with a grim look on his face. Margin back to 7. Poor pass for Anstey, picked off by Adam Gibson, and the Tasmanian goes coast to coast to add another 2. And now the Bullets will start celebrating. They lead by 9 with 15 seconds to play. And it is all over for the reigning champs. The team owned by Eddie Groves and the ABC Learning Centres have handed the reigning champions a grand final lesson to clinch their first title in 20 years and send the Bullets fans to Brisbaneland. Full time from the cage in Melbourne reads Brisbane 103, Melbourne 94 here on Fox Sports. They claim the grand final series 3-1 and unseat the reigning champs on their home floor. And as Big Joe gets up on the stage, we won't keep the Brisbane Bullets waiting any longer. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please put your hands together for the 2007 NBL champions, the Brisbane Bullets.
Series they had slow start in game one, but then they came on as gangbusters in the third quarter of game one and never really looked back. A big quarter by the Melbourne Tigers with 39 points, and then that was the only time that the Brisbane Bullets were on the second tier as far as this series was concerned. Great performance by everybody on the team. It was a great team effort, probably the best team effort I've seen by any team throughout this competition's history.
Well, Steve, I guess the Adelaide 36ers of 1986 might have other ideas, but as you say, a team effort from the Brisbane Bullets to snap a 20-year drought. And Joey Wright, when he arrived at the Brisbane Bullets, they'd lost 10 straight games, and in his 4 full seasons with this outfit, he's been a finalist every year, twice to the semi-finals, and now they climb to the top of the tree. And Sam McKinnon won his last title in 1996. They don't come around too often, and that's why they'll savor the moment now.
And I'm sure he will really appreciate this one a lot more than when he was playing with the Magic as a young guy. Probably thought if you play hard, you train hard, the good things will happen to you. You win championships, but you have to have a lot of breaks go your direction. You have to have team members that are all on the same page. Joey Wright was hungry. This was their year. They took advantage of it. They were healthy throughout most of the season. A lot of breaks went their way, but they deserved it. They played like a team. They played hard. I've never seen defense played like their team played, especially here in the grand final.
No, they have set a new standard in terms of defense in the National Basketball League, and that's saying something when you consider how tough the teams that Brian Gorgian are that he has coached. But the Brisbane Bullets, they won the preseason blitz back in September, defeating the Melbourne Tigers in the grand final, and they did it without 3 of their starters, and we wondered if anyone was going to be able to match it with them. They went on an NBL record winning streak of 21 games. They've won more matches than a Brisbane team has ever done. They've won more home matches consecutively now than any other team has done in Brisbane. And the Bullets Foundation members of the National Basketball League have been around for 29 seasons. And now they have 3 titles to their credit, just one short of the record held by Perth and Adelaide, and deserving winners. Players don't get a lot of respect sometimes in terms of their nous, but 80% of the NBL players predicted that either Brisbane or Melbourne would win the title, and they gave us a very good grand final series.
Yeah, they sure did. I mean, they came out there and did some great things, and every year we say, who is going to come out? Who's going to surprise us? Who's going to go to another level? And I think that player was Adam Gibson. He really had a super grand final series.
Congratulations to the Brisbane Bullets. Before we leave you, I'd like to congratulate our hard-working crew as well. It's been a long season for Fox Sports. Our producer Adam Howarth has held it all together with assistance from Kimberly Knox, Guy James, our director, everyone that works behind the scenes as well, Mark Benici and Cutting Edge, who just drag us around the country and get us from A to B and ready to rock and roll. And my co-commentator, that's why he's in the Hall of Fame, Steve Garfino. Another tremendous season.
It was a great season to see both of these teams in the grand final. We wanted it all season long. It was a great series, but either team we felt like could get hot and run off three straight. The Melbourne Tigers were capable of that. They looked like it from the opening tip. They were going to be tough, but Brisbane got it together, never got rattled, and showed the team that they were capable of being.
Well, that is all for 2007 on the NBL. It all kicks off Wednesday, the 19th of September, 2007. We head into a new season, but we'll leave you now with the NBL champions of 2007, the Brisbane Bullets.
Has been a Fox Sports production.